Welcome to Brussels, welcome to the status and strategy workshop. Summary of activities. So we are remembering, I think, the workshops, one in Istanbul, one, yeah, of course, the first workshop in Denmark at the Technical University. We had one in Barcelona, in Guildford. This is this picture. Here we had the special session of the EWSHM conference, the European Workshop on Structural Health Monitoring in Bilbao. When we are working, we are, I think, coming often across the website, of course, eCost, and also the cost website. So, but what, yeah, what is it about? But first, a closer look to the workshops. We had the first workshop with 65 participants from 23 countries, and the other workshops, second, third, and fourth, and fifth, around 40 participants from, and yes, and around 20 countries. So this is our working mode, and when we think we have about 130 participants, then it's approximately a third which is activated for each of the workshops. And country-wise, we have 27 countries, so there is around two-thirds or three-fifths of the countries who are at the moment associated to our cost action. It's this percentage which is involved. One important aspect is, I think, that we, for the fifth workshop, we did not have a management committee meeting. So we have reduced this in the second year of the action to one management committee meeting. But still, the number of participants stayed constant. So that's, I think, very important to, or it is an expression of getting the community going. First, we have to invest and in the way that the network needs really to come together, and then it's a sign that that it now goes more easy. Okay, but what is it about? You have been seeing the progress report at month 24, that's how it is called. It's about objectives, deliverables, networking impact, dissemination and exploitation of action results. I think this is also a point we need to think about, but I think we just had a perfect input for that by the cost director. And action successes, this is what should happen. But of course, what we should, what we cannot enforce or work on, really, we need to be free and open, and then it's perfect if it happens. Okay, well, the objectives, I think this is rather aligned. We want to enhance the benefit of structural health monitoring, and we want to apply decision analysis for that to assess the value of SHM before it is implemented. And then we want to improve the design, operation, life cycle integrity management of structures or any engineering systems for more cost-efficient, reliable, and safe strategies. So I think this points to the impact. This points to the point where we need to think about how to impact, how to show in throughout our working groups. So then this is the objective, and then there is there's aims and specific aims. And one aim is about the theoretical and methodological impact framework. I'm sorry. The workshop is about impact. Here I'm in the objectives. So it is the framework. And then there's an associated specific aim, the documentation of this theoretical basis. And that's basically done with the fact sheets in the workshop reports we have, and of course on the website with the presentations, and also within the action database. And then we have a two-step dissemination. We have internal dissemination. This goes especially to the database, and then this is at the same time this is our working base. Here we are exchanging the documents, so this is for internal dissemination and internal working. And then we have the we have publications where we disseminate it further to the community outside our action. But first we need to work, and I think it's also, it may be a good strategy if we are working stepwise and coordinate with each other. So this is about the first aim, which is associated to the objective. The second aim, this is about networking, collected expertise, and again, to the first aim, it is how to utilize the framework for practical applications in all a variety of aspects involving the design and asset management for engineering systems or structures or infrastructure systems. So I think the main interaction here in the network is related to working group 2. That's our biggest working group, and here this is the communities we are building on. And in the most basic distinction, it is the SHM community and it is the structural reliability community. We want to utilize the framework. We have been working on that. We have been documenting the framework. We are developing test cases. We have developed a common language that goes to the glossary, but the aim of the glossary was and still is to have the most important underlying wording in it. So we don't want any detailed wording and probably then it gets very complicated and can be also contradictory. So we need to have a solid foundation also in the communication. This is what the glossary is about. So we have within our action in network, when we think of other networks, then it's TU146. Jose Matos is here today. I have also name tags, but they are in my suitcase. We can take the name tags in the lunch break. And our dissemination channels, it is again our website and the database. So this is about the objectives, and there are more specific aims, appropriate and efficient tools. So this goes again to working group 2 and 3. I think this is very central and challenging at the same time. Here we have the development of practical examples. I think this is our focus now, also at this workshop. I'm waiting for Jochen, but he should show up soon, I think. Jochen Köhler. It is about the guidelines. I'm very happy that John joined today. So I think this is a good point in time to make plans for the standardization community, but of course at the same time it's even more important to think about a draft guideline in the for JCSS and for practical examples. This is what we wrote in the memorandum of understanding, so that we have the basis and then that the standardization committees would be open. so if we have something. And educational activities, so this is also should be a focus in the second half of the action. We have not started that yet. So we are coming to from the objectives to the deliverables. I think I mentioned them in every workshop opening. That's what we are after. So it's dedicated dissemination activities. That's our homepage. It's so that goes to workshops and all activities we are organizing. A library of tools and algorithms we would like to have, and then the both deliverables associated to standardization or a step before, a guideline, one for the scientists in the probabilistic model code and one for the practitioners, how to utilize the things we are doing here. So the action website is under development. I think you have noticed it's getting better, and it will be further developed. But I think we have quite comprehensively documented our events, the presentations, and we have many videos of the workshops and presentations. And of course, we have our database developed. Dissemination activities, we had 5 workshops, 3 special sessions. One was in the ICASP conference where we even went internationally. Of course, we are going for international conferences, but they should be in Europe. Or this should be our basis here for COST. But of course, we should also disseminate internationally. It goes to the special session at the EWSHM in Bilbao this year, and this goes to the MSSCE special session, RILEM conference, also this year in August. 7 scientific missions we have performed, and we can find 30 publications. Okay, for the library of tools and algorithms, this is still under development, and mainly we have collected fact sheets from the 3rd and 4th and also the 5th workshop. Okay, here I think when we have a closer look to standardization, we can say that in our network there is representatives from all these organizations. So this is from the networking side, I think, covered. But the next steps are necessary. And on the work on the guideline, we have not started yet, but maybe the work of the working groups could be associated to that in terms of we have a basis and we have material we can work with. Additional outputs and achievements, I think this goes to the joint workshop in Zagreb, which is 5 or 6 weeks, right? And associated to that, a special issue, a journal issue on SHM value and performance assessment of existing structures. And we have been working on the STSM program because I think this is a very good tool, the STSMs. I think this is very central. I will come back to that because we are supporting here young researchers and we are supporting capacity building. And at the same time, these people are may not be so busy as very senior researchers. So I think here we are investing in the right tool to scientifically accelerate activities, and also we are there is some scientific resources we can activate with SCSMs. We should also talk about what we have learned, how a cost action works, or a scientific networking program, how does it work? So it's not a research project. No, we don't have any money for supporting research, but the way to work is crowdworking. So that's why we have the different levels of organization. So we have the steering committee, we have the management committee. The steering committee is less people, and then we have the management committee, which is more people, and then we have the participants, which is even more people. So all these people can do a small bit, but we need to organize that. And that's crowdworking. We need to find a specific topic. I think a very good example is categorizations. We do the categorization, and then we are working with calls, we are working with the network, we are asking them for small contributions, but very many small contributions can then grow into something big. So this is the way to work. We work here with the network and we do crowdworking. Okay, deliverables. So then I think this is also very important. It goes also to the point how we are working with the cost action. So it is crowdworking, and I think we had 2 years' time. It is about having organized scientific support by using the cost action for national applications, using the topics. There can be direct support. I'm very happy to provide or to support calls with letters of intent or letters of support. So this is another point, how we are working. So very important is here publications. Cost publication, I can say this again, is that if there was at least two different cost countries involved, where the authors are belonging to, it doesn't work if just one author works in two cost countries. That doesn't work. But it must be two persons. When you talk about Horizon 2020, then we have one success. The Infrastar Marie Curie ITN is funded, and this was the proposal was submitted in the early days of this cost action. But the topic of the cost action, I think John remembers that entered the application. And that's why we listed it here. And it may have been a part of the evaluation. And then I think we also had a little luck here that it was finally funded. And then we have had two non-successful Horizon 2020 proposals, but I'm a little in doubt about these numbers here. So we have listed three, and it was the ones I knew of or I was involved in. But I cannot imagine that a network of 130 participants across Europe just produces three proposals of Horizon 2020 projects. So this is what I cannot imagine, and I think we all have to work here on openly communicating it. I think we should at least list the attempts. This is not too difficult, and of course it would be very good if there was a successful proposal and we are disseminating this in our action network so that all the people are motivated, and in the end we will also profit from that, because it is the action network is there to support, and I think we are covering very many fields. So I would like to encourage the proposal writing, but also the open communication, and finally then also the documentation. Okay, networking. So actually this is a picture of the first management committee meeting here in Brussels. We could say we have really widened our network here in the fifth workshop, but maybe that's a little camera trick. Oh, there's Jochen. Hi.
Hi.
Welcome. So I think this is also important to have in the background. What is the networking about? It's of course about the integration of knowledge and experience. It's about the integration of different expertises. It's not just research. It should also be engineers and operators, and maybe authorities working together. It's relevant experts and relevance. Yes, and this is how we should utilize as the researchers our network. It is, I think, the operators and the authorities and senior industrial people who can advise us in which direction it should go. And I think this is the point here about we should also ensure their contribution. It's about innovation. Networking is about innovation and communicating innovation. I think Helder has done a very good job from the beginning. So I'm looking forward to the continuation of that. And networking is about distributed anchorage across Europe and worldwide. I think this is something we need to work on. So putting a little more light on the individual points. I think our network is substantial here in Europe. I think, what is the maximum number of countries we can arise?
36.
Okay, we have 27. We have two requests. One from Slovakia and one from Luxembourg. So this will soon be 29. So I think this is fine. This is also fine. This number here, it may grow a little. We should be sure to We should make sure to involve anybody who can contribute. So if there was a good contribution, I think we should be very open and happy to involve these people. Excuse me. We have, even in the networking, written, but this is a memorandum of understanding, paste and copy. We have been writing that there is a highly specialized and thinly populated research discipline regarding methods and tools. And yeah, this is true. But we are very happy that in working group 3 there is about 30 people, Eleni and Daniel. So this is quite a network to work with. This point we already took. Maybe this is interesting. It's about 30% of the participants are affiliated with commercial research and engineering institutions and infrastructures, owners, operators, and authorities. So it's about 1/3 of the project network. I think this is still a good number. This is fine, but we could develop this here to 40 or 50, especially as we are after case studies. we have also introduced to ensure that the framework is practically applicable and relevant, an advisory board consisting of Helmut Wenzel. Inga wanted to come, but she wrote me an email today that she's ill. we have Peter Hart from the German Highway Research Institution, and we have regular academic board meetings, and their advice is documented in our database. We could work on making that a little more visible. This is what we will do. Generation of innovation. So this goes to our innovation committee, very active from the, I think there was a document even for the first workshop, and then the second there was a session. And this also goes to the advice from the Innovation Committee to the SCSMs, and that has been realized. So this is very good activity. Okay, I think we see here now that the activities we are organizing, these workshops, and special sessions in Europe and worldwide, that these activities can be associated to different parts of the memorandum of understanding and what we are asked for. It is about networking. It's about the scientific plan we are working on. So I think this is the. What this slide is about. international research community, this is what we have achieved. Not to the extent we would like to achieve it. We have included Australia as an international partner country. We have this joint activity, but we should focus here more. And the extent of networking, this was what we are asked for, and I think this is very important for cost. So, for instance, the SCSMs, 3 out of 7 went to female participants, 4 out of 7 to early career investigators. InclusiveNet target countries, there are quite a few here in our network, and we even had 2 workshops. we had 1 workshop in Turkey, and then there will is 1 more planned here this year in Croatia and Zagreb. Okay, impacts. So we are in point D, I think, until F it goes, but impact is one very important thing. We need to, I think, have the common understanding here. This is why I'm presenting this here. So we have the categories scientific, technological, economic, society, and then time horizons achieved, foreseen within 2 years, to 5 years, to 10 and 10 plus. Each of the picture stands for, this is a scientific impact. This could be the technological impact, we invent the wheel. Economic impact we may find already because the value of information of structural health monitoring is can be tremendous, and it is there. It is well developed, but nobody quantified the value of information of that yet. And these numbers, this is 1831 or 1%, but this is what we are after. We want to show where structural health monitoring is extremely efficient, and I think 31% here in terms of risk and cost reduction, this is quite a number, and this is significant. And of course we identify strategies which are not efficient. Okay, and we are after societal impact, and then I think this goes to the points the cost director did make, which may be about life safety, and I think this is also something to keep in mind. We asked for impacts in these categories, and I think we have I think we can cover all here to quite a large extent. There is technological impacts also, because this thinking of very efficient SHM strategies, this can also be done not scientifically but just in engineering, and by knowing what is the context, what we would like to achieve, and that goes to the integrity management. And then there is there's very efficient technologies, so that sets the context for a technological impact, but also for innovation. I think, in my mind, this is perfect, because many people are developing and without really knowing what the things they are doing and what they are very good at, what is really good for. And if we can provide this context here, and we do provide it, then this can have a tremendous technological impact, and this should boost innovation. What did I wrote about the impacts? We for sure have scientific and also technological. I think this was together here. So scientific impact for quantifying the value of SHM and making the scientific fields accessible. We have evidence of improved economic efficiency, and we have quantified it. And then we should go, it should come also the technological, the industrial impacts, So that there should be new business opportunities for SMEs or for large enterprises, and which should then lead to increased competitiveness and enhanced management of risks to individuals, environment, and economy. So I think this goes very much to the societal level. Point E, dissemination and exploitation of action results. Here, I think we need to think more about what are the most efficient way of disseminating and also of exploiting. But of course, we are in the first half, and this should be more facilitated in the second half of the action. Success stories. We have been asked to document breakthroughs, scientific, technological, socioeconomic. Policy implementation is also a success story. And capacity building, meaning helping someone in the action here, participants to develop their professional capacities. Yeah, maybe you will also say something to
yes.
Point E and F, probably. So that seems to be under development, as I understood the cost director. So this is very important that, so I'm providing the context here in terms of the progress report. But we should also follow the latest developments. And I think with setting up this cost action, we made a scientific breakthrough in the field of value of structural health monitoring analysis. Because we have a wide network. It's a unique project worldwide on this topic. I think this is something extremely good already, and well, success stories or impact. I think we have the potential here for scientific socio-economic breakthrough, and yeah, because we are working with the quantification of risk reduction and cost reduction. Okay, thank you for your attention. This was to set the context and going through what we have achieved in the last 2 years. Thanks.